Yes.
Shettleston!
Alright, what do you think Shettleston was like 100 years ago?
Really old.
Yeah.
I think it was so old and they had black and white pictures and stuff like the Victorians or something.
If I was walking down like Shettleston Road 100 years ago, then I would like imagine coming up and then like there'd be like old shops, if you know what I mean. Like was there like news agents and stuff, like newspapers, like milk and all that?
100 years ago there was dinosaurs. I wanted to see dinosaurs.
My dad told me there used to be like no shops, like the shopping centre, and that wasn't here. It was just houses.
The Tesco actually used to be a bottle works.
Uh-huh. Yeah, anyway, Salmon Services used to be a rope box. Is that like where they make
ropes? Yeah. And behind Tesco there used to be
coal mines and all that.
Yeah, used to be the coal mines. And they had, when they first got trains, they travelled food.
Shettleston train station was at, like, travelling. They travelled to different countries.
Down at my, like, you know how where, like, down from the kangaroo, like the pelican bit? Right there, used to be like a massive, like, play area and stuff. It used to be like that, but there were swimming baths, there was four libraries right by that.
Did you know that people had to use horses to travel in? Like,
You went through mud, all your clothes and all that
could
fail out.
Yeah, you
could.
Oh,
God, I feel bad for the horses!
And the horses, in the way here at Edinburgh, they only got two stops to get water.
Horse abuse, you guys!
Do you think it was dinosaurs in Easter?
No.
No? Why not?
Maybe in the zoo.
Dinosaurs have existed that day. Oh my God, here, dinosaurs. Is this like the 70s?
In the field too, behind the garden, there was an Anderson shelter where people used to go in, like, to hide from the bombs and stuff. And it's still there, like, from 100 years ago, it's still there.
If my house was made back then, I would like to know who used to be, like, the first owner of it. Who used to stay in it.
There's this app on Google and you can go in and find out people from World War 1 and World War 2 who have been to house.
I would like to know what the schools would be like and what they would learn, if it was like a different way from what we learn.
I want to know what class has done for me.
How long has this been a building?
Yeah, how long has this been a building?
I don't know.
That's
what I
look
up.
Like, what they meant to wear? We've not got like any designer clothes.
Or like did the last season have to have dresses?
I'd like to know what they would do if they never had friends with their kids.
How long has Fuse been up?
How long has Fuse been up?
I'm not that up.
Like, if there wasn't many shops and stuff around about, then what would people do? Like, to entertain themselves?
What games are we playing again? Like, is it coming up on what you meant to do?
We can't even live
without it. Pictures of old Shettleston. Okay, can I read this? Shettleston is in Glasgow history. The greenhouse was built about 1703 by John Pettigrew and landed in Shettleston during the early part of the 19th century. That was Shettleston's 1700s.
Whoa.
That's only a big, that's a drawing. Oh, and then half cameras, like they could produce
that's
color.
That's one.
Why do you find this stuff interesting?
Because we live in, well, as we live in Shettleston, it's really interesting to find out old history and that, like, see what's happening.
Where's Higgins? Interesting to hear what happened when I was younger.
I want to know about the people that were there and how they dealt with it.
It's kind of weird, but I get like a good feeling that when I read stuff, like, I don't know why, but I get a really good feeling when I like, do history.
Yeah, it's like when you're like doing something you like.
You get that feeling when you're doing something you enjoy.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what history is.
Dinosaurs would go, and you could have just punched them in the face.